What we've done is taken pure maple syrup that we tested the invert sugar on, and we know we've got a very low invert sugar content in that pure maple syrup. The lighter the grade, usually, the lower the invert sugar is. What we did is we took it and we brought it up to 234 degrees. We put it in a bath of cold water so it cools rapidly, and we sprayed water on a surface so it doesn't form sugar crystals on the top of the taffy. We let the taffy cool down for a day till it got to room temperature. And this is the product that we have right here now, is this maple taffy that we're gonna put into the Lapierre maple cream machine. This cream machine makes a very fine textured maple cream. And what the beauty of it is the fact that you can dispense the maple cream right into the containers without a lot of air pockets, which cause a lot of separation. It will increase your profit at the farm. We know that by having maple cream that we could sell wholesale and that we had on our retail shelves at the farm, the first year that we did it, we increased our yield by 6%. Our gross income was increased by 6%. So, sure, the machines do have a cost associated to them, but what they will do is provide you with a tremendous amount of return. Let's see if we can get the machine started and see what happens. What we've got here is the taffy, that seal that we made up a couple days ahead of time. And what we're gonna do right now is put it into the maple cream machine. This here is taffy that we made on Wednesday, and we're gonna put it in, we're gonna let it recirculate through the machine until it has a very fine texture. Right now it looks very wet, but, and it's cold, obviously, this is cold. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna end up letting it recirculate through the machine until it becomes dull. Once it's dull, then we know that the maple cream, we've got the right sugar crystals that are established, and then we can start to dispense it in the maple cream containers that we have right here. The pump is gonna pick it up. You can hear it start to work, and it should come out of here shortly. This is so far advanced in comparison to the way we used to make maple cream. This is a much better way to make it. They've got a really nice smooth transition, and this is going to work very well. Make sure that you put enough taffy into the machine so that you have a continuous flow. Otherwise, you end up with these air bubbles. And we're trying to avoid the air bubbles. So what you really want to do is probably, it looks to me as though maybe about a gallon might be a minimum. So now you can see, what I'd like, well, see now we have a continuous flow. And what's gonna happen is you're gonna see the more that it goes through the gear pump, it's gonna warm up a little bit. That's a plus. You've established the sugar crystals, it's gonna become a little bit more fluid. And if you notice right now, there's still some heavier sugar crystals. Those sugar crystals are gonna get crushed by the gear pump. So therefore, it's gonna make a finer 1 gallon, put it in one pot. You can boil down the second gallon, put it in the second pot. You can boil down the third gallon, put it in the third pot. And then once you get the machine started, once you get towards the end a little bit, you can just go back and start your second or your third batch. You don't have to necessarily stop. Now you can see how it's changed. What it's doing, it's giving a really nice sugar crystal.
Color's changed.
Yes, color's changed. It's always good to have a spatula close by.
What's the life expectancy of one of those gear pumps?
Oh, it'll last a long time. It's a lot better than on a filter press. On a filter press, you're running diatomaceous earth through with your maple syrup. Diatomaceous earth is difficult, it's hard. So, no, life expectancy on a gear pump is, this will almost last indefinitely. I can't see where.
Can you take that too far?
No, what'll happen, it'll soften up, which it's gonna do right now. No, you can't. It'll change a little bit, but you can't really take it too far. No. This should have probably had. What we end up doing is making the maple taffy ahead of time by about a day. We'll take pure maple syrup that we check the invert sugar content, that we know it's going to crystallize. We'll bring it up to 234 degrees. And once we bring it up to 234, then what we'll do is we'll take it off the source of heat, and we'll put it in a pot, and we'll put it in water so the water can circulate underneath the bottom and around the sides. We'll let it cool down for a day until it gets down to room temperature. Once it's down to room temperature, then we know we can use it. What Jane's doing right now, she's dispensing it. That's what the beauty of these machines are, is the fact you can dispense it into a container.
Yeah.
With the older maple cream machines, I'm not saying they're bad, I'm saying they're different. I'm saying that if anybody's gonna make an investment into a Lapierre cream machine, this is the latest technology, and it really, really works. It works real good. Look how smooth that sugar crystal is. And it increases your sales. If you're willing to go that extra distance, you're gonna be surprised at how much demand there are for the value-added products. A lot of folks make maple syrup. What cuts us above the rest is, what do we do with maple confections? Do we make maple cream, maple taffy, sugar on snow? Do we make maple candy? And you know what, folks? We're home on the farm. What difference does it make? If we can get more value out of what we're making, why not do it?